1, 2, 3.
Yo, this is Storyteller. I'll let your boy.
Yo, it's Storyteller. Holla at your boy. I'm over there on Kings Highway in Arsenal, y'all. They're having a balloon release for the victims of the shooting at the school. One love. Holla at your boy. Yo, it's Storyteller. Holla at your boy. I'm here with this young man. We having a candlelight tonight for the victims that were shot at this high school. And I want to get your perspective on this and introduce yourself to the world.
How y'all doing? My name is Christopher. What I just got to say on this whole situation is very sad. There's a lot that's going on in the city. The main problem is our cops, man. They show a lot that they don't care about us. Most definitely people with melanin like ourselves. A lot of people hurting right now, going through it. And it's real sad that these babies got to go through what we have to go through for centuries.
Yes, and I'd like to say on behalf of the cops, the first responders up at this school, high school, they did very well. All cops is not bad, and I had to commend them on what they was doing. And my heart goes out to the family there in my prayer. And we want to change, you know, what's going on around here. You know, the youngsters out here, it's a lot of mental illness that's going on. And I have ideas as well, you know, to help, you know, with some of these youngsters. So if anybody out there hear me interested in what I have to present to the table, I have a blueprint on how to help these youngsters, especially ones that's 14 years old and younger, that's stealing cars and doing burglaries and stuff and getting right back out. I have a plan for that. You can get in touch with me on RoRo the Storyteller. All you have to do is send a message. We got resources, but all you youngsters out there that's feeling like there's no hope for you or no one to help you or no one care about you, I want to let you know it's a lot of people out here who care about you. Get in contact with me and I got resources. I got people that will help you.
What I want to say is don't ever think that you lost. Don't ever think that just the streets is it. Me personally, I come from a place where I lived in vacant buildings. I've had no water. I've had no food, no lights. But right now, I've actually been blessed. I got my own place right now working on my car. So don't always, you can always work on it. It'll come. You just got to find it.
That's right. Have patience and stay focused and never give up. Because the last thing to die is hope. And long as you live, there's always hope. One love, Storyteller. Holla at your boy.
Others harvest. We are each other's business. We are each other's magnitude and bond. On Monday morning, people who were about the business of community gathered around, came to be educated, to serve, to educate, to have black joy as resistance, to enjoy one another as students, faculty, and staff, and that business was interrupted. But we are bigger than the business of evil, because as long as my business is community, my business can never go out.
Amen. And the memory of Alex, as well as Miss Kushka, going back home.
Amen. Amen. Glory. Glory. Glory.
Oh. other people in your life.
Yes.
Everybody is not here to judge you.
Come on
Everybody
now.
Everybody is not here to use you. Nobody's here to make fun of you.
That's right.
Please just ask for help. My daughter had a thing of saying, Mama, you doing too much. Parents, continue to do too much.
Yeah. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. Yes, sir.
You may release.
Yo, it's a storyteller. Holla at your boy. I'm over here at the school, CVPA, where the shootings is at. And I want to pay my respects to the victim families, the victims, and y'all are in my prayer.
The heartache of this place, there are children that flower the trees.
Okay, I would like to get your thoughts, you know, on this situation, this horrible, humble situation that had happened.
Personally, I don't know, I'm lost for words. I got kids. This is a nice school, this is a nice community. This is one of the nicest communities I've seen, not one of the nicest communities I've seen since I've been out here, so... It's crazy that, you know, dark energies and dark people, hurt people, you know, did this. And, you know, I just had to, you know, put a special prayer in for their families and, you know, for the person who did it, because obviously they was hurt and in a dark place. So just praying for everybody, you know. And, you know, it's just been on my mind. I've been praying about it. Every day, I'm new to prayer, so just me coming here today, I felt like I was led here to pray. So, I don't know, I'm at a loss for words. I don't want to overspeak and I don't want to underspeak, because you have to speak. So, I don't know.
Well, I appreciate you coming out here, allowing me to do this interview with you. I'm the storyteller. One love. Yo, yo, it's the storyteller. Holla at your boy. Today I got this young man right here named Courtney, and I want you to express how you feel about this situation, sir.
We want to send condolences to the families, and we want to give strength to the survivors of the incident and the situation. We want to give honors to the officers that came in and applied their knowledge and training to a situation that could have been a lot worse. So we're gonna give praise to God. We're gonna give love to those who didn't make it, and love to those who did make it. Peace and condolences to all the families.
There's heaven and sunshine too. The spirit of peace moves.
Love, Holly.
Holler at your boy, the storyteller. We got this, y'all.
Yo, 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 it's the storyteller. Holler at your boy. Today, I'm up here at the school with a tragic event that had happened, you all. And I got a young lady right here. She want to explain what's going on here.
All right, you guys. So today we will be doing a Family Undivided March for Justice and performance. We will be marching in protest of the gun laws that in Missouri that are so lenient. We would like more stricter legislation on gun laws because we feel that if it was more strict, then it could have prevented the tragedy that happened on October 24th. After the march, we will be coming back to the field, and if you see the stage in the back, we will be having a few performances from the CVPA student body. We have choir, we have dancers, we're going to have food vendors, Chick-fil-A will be out here, food trucks. It's going to be a really good time, and just ultimately to celebrate the lives of those who were lost and celebrate the lives of those who survived. Because, you know, just being in that type of situation, we've seen so many candlelights and we've been to the funerals and we've cried and we had our sorrows. And so now it's time to smile, now it's time to come together, now it's time for unity, and now it's time for Family Undivided. So, yep, that's the event for today. We just gonna get it cracking, have a few performances set up, and it's gonna be real entertaining.
And I like to say that I like your attitude, and most of the students that I interview around here, they are resilient, and we ain't gonna stop the fight, y'all.
Hello.
Because they are the most important. They gonna shape tomorrow. One love. Holla at your boy.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is wonderful. All praises be to the King of Kings and the Lord our God. He is wonderful.
Hey guys, my name is Amari. I'm a junior here at Central Visual Performing Arts High School. So I've been here all 3 years. And today we have an event called A Family Undivided. And basically it's just to show the community that even though we experience horrific event on that Monday morning, that we are still a school that stands together and that we still have unity, that even through all these events, we show each other love and show the love that we matter.
To me, this event is just me, like, we just showing everybody, like, even though we can't really be in school right now, we can still all come together, we can still do what we came here to do in the first place, which is be who we are, you know, come together as a whole, as a family. You know, just support each other, be for each other, especially at times like this. And then we're showing the community like what we actually about. Like, even though the school situation, we still take everything seriously.
My name is Tristan. I'm a sophomore. I've been going for 2 years. And it's like, even something like you never expected to happen. But even though it did happen, you can like come back as a community, come back stronger, and try your best to recover from it. No matter if you got to take counseling, talk to people, and do all these things to recover, even though it was really dramatic.
Yeah, we doing this. We out here, y'all. We finna move on, y'all. We resilient and we strong. We ain't gonna give up the fight because the youth are the future. One love. First responders, I want to salute you all for doing a marvelous and an excellent job. y'all did the right thing. Y'all showed the world how to respond to something like this. And I want the state officials to know that I'm a youth athlete. I love the youth. And I have a blueprint on how to help the youth. Anybody want to get in contact with me? I'm on a YouTube channel. It's called RoRo the Storyteller. And it goes on to Instagram and my Facebook page as well. We have to do something about this. I feel that the state official is not aggressive enough towards the youth to help save them. That's just my opinion. We have to save these youngsters out here. They are our everything. They are the most important. They are the future. Without them, we don't have a future. So I'm asking all the state officials, all the representatives, whoever, get in contact with me. I have information, I have resources, and I have things that I can present to the table to help the youth. And for the youngsters out there, or anybody else that's going through life feeling like they're lonely, they don't have nobody, there's no one listening to them, get in contact with me, RoRo the Storyteller. I have resources. I can help you. There's a lot of people out in this world that loves and care about you. Reach out to us. Don't hold things in. Don't be that way. Just reach out to us. I'm pleading with you to reach out to me. I got y'all back. One love. The Storyteller. Holler at your boy.
They say pressure bust pipe. I say also produce diamonds. I was once told by a wise guy, where you least expect can be the most greatest of heights.